The global food system today is broken, leaving billions of people either underfed or overweight, while driving the planet towards a climate catastrophe. Did you know it takes 477 gallons of water to produce just 1 pound of eggs? A staggering one-third of all greenhouse gas emissions, which is more than the emissions from transportation, heating, lighting, and air conditioning, all combined, comes from the food system. It's clear that our food system needs to be transformed for the sake of our planet and for the future of humankind. Today on Mission Driven, we're talking to a founder who's working hard to do just that. Josh Chetrick, the co-founder and CEO of Eat Just. So Josh, could you tell us a little bit about Eat Just and what you guys do?
So we're a food technology company, and we have decided to challenge what I think is the most commonly held assumption in food, and that is an egg needs to come from an animal. We don't think that needs to be the case. We think an egg can come from a plant. And we build a technology and a business model and a brand around that idea. And the consequence of approaching in that way means an egg that uses a lot less land and a lot less water, entirely free of cholesterol. And we think in the next decade or two, you're going to have more people eating eggs from plants than eggs from chickens because they're going to taste better, they're going to be healthier, and they're going to be a lot more affordable.
Josh, how did Eat Just come about? Can you tell us a little bit about the history of the company?
I was motivated to start this from spending a handful of years going back and forth living in sub-Saharan Africa. I spent time in Liberia, in Kenya, in South Africa. Was motivated by not eating very well growing up. And then finally was most motivated by my best friend, also named Josh, who really opened up my eyes to how we need to fix the food system. And it turns out that animal protein is a big reason why the food system needs a lot of help. And it turns out the most consumed animal protein in the world is a chicken egg. About 1.4 trillion chicken eggs were consumed in 2019. So our idea was, can we find a plant that will be better than an egg?
So how do you actually make Eat Just eggs?
Ultimately, the quest was to identify a plant protein that would scramble in a pan. It turned out that plant was a bean called the mung bean. Now, growing up in Alabama, I never heard of the mung bean, but the mung bean's been in our food system for over 4,000 years. It turns out there's a protein inside the mung bean that has these scrambling properties. The second step is take that mung bean and mill it into a flour. Third step is take that flour, spin it down at high rates of speed so the protein separates from the fat and the fiber and the starch. So now we got the thing that scrambles separated from everything else. We had oil, turmeric, some other minor ingredients. We put it in a bottle and you put it in a pan and enjoy it.
I feel like we all know that meat proteins are bad, but there's also more reasons. Like, aren't plant proteins so much better for you than traditional meat protein?
Yeah, when you think about the reasons why plant protein is preferable, the first is human health, and then the second is planet health. So from a human health perspective, think free of cholesterol, think free of antibiotics, significantly less saturated fat. When you think planet health, think less land use, fewer carbon emissions, less water. And then a reason that relates to the reason why we're not in the same room together, zoonotic disease. So COVID-19 is a zoonotic disease, and that's an abstract term. All it means is a disease that jumps from an animal to a human. More human beings have died of zoonotic disease since I was born than at almost any other time in human history, is because the human animal has decided to encroach in the other animal territory, right? We devastate forests. We decide to put lots of animals in small spaces. And all of those things elevate risk. And if we're really trying to build a society where we can optimize for human health, right, where we can optimize for planet health, choosing plants instead of animals ends up being the smart, sensible, sustainable move.
zoom in a little bit on the sustainability portion of this. What's the impact of choosing to eat a just egg over traditional eggs?
A chicken, which typically lays about an egg every single day, that consumes lots of soy and corn, that whole cycle requires a lot of energy. And the energy is in the form of many, many acres of land. So just egg uses about 95% less land than a conventional chicken egg. The second is water. So all that soy and corn that you feed all these chickens needs to grow, and it needs to be watered. And just egg uses about 95% less water than a chicken egg. Then the final is carbon emissions. So all that soy and all that corn and all that land takes fertilizer and lots of other inputs. Those chicken barns require electricity. And just egg uses about 97% fewer carbon emissions than a conventional chicken egg. It's going to be significantly below the cost of the cheapest egg. And from a micronutrition, from a macronutrition perspective, it's going to be so many orders of magnitude better. And eventually we're going to get to the place, Josh, where 5-10 years from now, 75% of people are going to prefer it to a pasture-raised egg.
So amazing. I love what you're doing. So, I mean, you started with eggs and you've got a couple products now. What else is in the pipeline, and what are the other kind of products you're building to fix the problems in our food system?
A more long-term project for us is meat. Now, our approach to meat is entirely different. We actually get cells from animals. So we identify nutrients to feed those cells. And then we manufacture those cells at scale. And the end product is actual animal meat.
So what's changed at your company during COVID? How are you supporting your employees, your community, and keeping people a little bit more connected while we're all apart?
We've got a great team on our people side that put together a whole series of processes and programs to make sure that folks are getting the mental support they might need, because it's not always easy to, especially if you're not hanging around people, to be alone. So we put that in place. And in the manufacturing setting, we have a manufacturing facility in Appleton, Minnesota, a tiny little town in western Minnesota. We have to take a whole bunch of different precautions to make sure that our employees stay safe. It's everything from temperature checks when you go in to testing. You realize, and I think most of my team realizes, that COVID is a zoonotic disease, and we're engaged in something that is not disconnected from that. The mission of the company is about reducing risk of things like this happening in the future.
What advice do you have for other companies that are navigating COVID to best support employees' well-being while maintaining, you know, their focus?
There's an opportunity, particularly because you're not physically around people, even more to encourage even more transparent dialogue. Think about the mental health facilities and support that you're providing to your employees. You're not going to solve every problem, but you can be there in a way that helps to make things a little bit better.